Chuey Martinez, movie fanatic. And this is Erich Allman, combat medic, EMT, and DMT with 20 years of experience. Join us and our team of weapon experts as we analyze the demonstrations of the world's most lethal items from El Rey's Man-at-Arms Art of War, hosted by Danny Trejo. Right here on History's Deadliest Weapons. Which weapon is the deadliest? Let's learn a little history about the G.
The G was an amazing battlefield weapon. It was one of the most used back in the day. The notion of having these two crossbars and the crescent, that opening is like an H-beam. And you've got the two crescents, which are like axes. It still have the strength, but you've lost the weight, so you can move it much more efficiently. So you've got your point, you've got your chopping, you've got your hooking and pulling. It's a very versatile head for a pole arm.
A weapon like this, Erich, what are your thoughts on this thing?
It's thin enough to fit through the bone structure as long as you don't hit the sternum.
All right.
So going through those ribs and those intercostal spaces, that would cause some serious damage.
And is the blade strong enough to pierce through a human body?
It would definitely at least pierce. Is it sharp enough to actually go through?
If I were to go at you in the head or the skull, what would be like the prime spot to hit you on?
I would go for the triangle of death. From the corners of your mouth to the eyes, it'll go right back towards the brain stem.
That's the deadly one.
You're dead.
All right, let's see the G in action. Let's get a slice in.
Danny, you want to give it a try?
You know what? Maybe I can break that skull.
Oh, right in there.
Oh, that right there, going through the eye socket.
Yes.
Obviously, it's going right up in your brain. You're dead.
You're dead. And you're losing an eyeball. Now we're moving on to the mannequin. Let's see what happens. Oh. So, Erich, let's talk about these wounds.
The spear could go in to the lungs, or go through the thoracic cavity, through the ribs, and get into there and get some vital organs.
We just saw the G in action, and now we actually have our buddy Robbie here, who is our on-set victim. Okay. As you can see, there was plenty of damage done. Correct. So what do we got here, brother?
As you can see, up here definitely pierced the liver. And then the spleen is back here, and you've got your lungs. This is your intestine area.
So if we got up in there, he would definitely be holding himself like this.
Right.
And groaning like, ah.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
I'm hurting.
And I don't know if I'd want to be hitting the groin area either. Definitely wouldn't be having kids after that.
No, you would not be. Let's talk about, you know, some of the sizes of these wounds. Does size matter?
In this case, yes.
Okay.
When you're doing penetrating wounds, they'll go through smaller and they actually get bigger as they're going through on the exit wounds. And there's more damage done internally. Like here, the reason we've got so much sand dripping down through all these is that it did hit the organs inside, that liver. That's gonna cause massive bleeding inside. And that would most likely be fatal.
So up here, not so much.
No, but these two and then the groin.
Brother, is it a stealth killer or a shelf killer?
The eye socket was obviously a killer right there.
Yes.
And then going in through the ribs, I'm gonna have to say stealth killer.
Yeah, me too. Thank you so much for joining us, brother.
It's been a great time.
Hey guys, I'm your host, Chuey Martinez, and make sure to check out more videos from Man-at-Arms, Art of War, and History's Deadliest Weapons on the right and hit the subscribe button on the left.